Hi, this is David Dusek, senior writer with Golf Week Magazine, and welcome to this week's edition of the Winner's Circle. I'm joined this week by Titleist PGA Tour rep Chris Tootin. Chris, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, David. How about you?
I'm doing really well. Thanks very much. Chris is going to tell us a little bit about Robert Streb's golf equipment. Robert was the winner last week at the 2014 McGladrey's Classic down in Sea Island, Georgia. And one of the things that sort of strikes me, Chris, about his setup is that this is a guy who's got a 2 through 9 iron. We see 2 irons here and there on the PGA Tour, but is Robert one of those guys that carries a 2 iron regularly, or is this a course-specific setup? Does he sometimes drop in a hybrid club or a fairway wood, or is he a guy who loves the deuce?
Yeah, Robert's not a guy that messes around with his clubs very much. He keeps the 2 iron in the bag quite often. I think he feels very good about it when he has to hit shots off a tee for accuracy and a certain yardage that he needs to hit. And, you know, a straight-faced club like a 2 iron is going to provide a little bit more a tighter shot pattern, and which on the PGA Tour, there are some holes out there that you need that for.
Yeah, for sure. No doubt about it. Now, he's carrying that 2 through 9 iron in the 714 CB. Now, that's a cavity back, a slightly perimeter-weighted club. Still is going to give you a lot of shot-shaping ability there, but I think a lot of people associate better players, obviously pros on the PGA Tour, with blades. Titleist has, obviously, Robert playing the CB. You've got Bill Haas in the CB. You also have guys like Zach Johnson, Jason Duffner playing the 714 AP2, which has some perimeter weighting as well. Are you noticing a trend of more guys, maybe the slightly younger generation, the 30, 32 years of age, younger generation, playing more perimeter weighted, more forgiving golf clubs, or is this simply a matter of guys looking around for something that suits their particular game?
Yeah, I think that it's more players looking for clubs that suit their game more than a trend. You know, Titleist, we offer a great product line between our 714 AP2, our 714 CB, and 714 MB. And what it allows all these players to do is get exactly what they're looking for. They can get a clean muscle back blade, which we see a lot of players play. That's probably our number one iron on the PGA Tour. Our second iron on the PGA Tour is the AP2. You know, the CB is a little bit more closer to an MB than it is to an AP2. The AP2 has a lot more built in, and that CB just gives the players a little bit more forgiveness than a traditional MB might.
Gotcha. Interesting stuff. Here's a complete list of the stuff that Robert had down in Sea Island when he won the McGladrey Classic. For a driver, he used a Titleist 913 D3 with 9.5 degrees of loft and an Alba Latour Blue 65 TX shaft. His fairway wood is a Titleist 913 FD with 15 degrees of loft and a Fujikura Mitore VC 7.2X shaft. His irons, as we mentioned, are Titleist 714 CBs, a 2 through 9 iron, and those had True Temper Dynamic Gold S300 shafts. His wedges are a Titleist Vokey Design SM5, an F-grind 46 degree that's been bent to 47, an M-grind 56 that's been bent to 55 degrees, and he also has a Titleist Vokey Design V-prototype 60 degree wedge. All those have True Temper Dynamic Gold S300 shafts. His putter is a Scotty Cameron for Titleist Go Low Knucklehead prototype, and his golf ball of choice is a Titleist Pro V1X. Chris, thanks once again for joining me inside the Winner's Circle.
Thank you, David. I appreciate it.
Great. And thank you for joining me, and I'll look forward to seeing you real soon.